Hello again, and welcome to my channel for all things Unity. In my past few videos, I focus on Unity Reflect. Today, I'm going to be doing something a little different with a new product we offer called Unity Forma. In the same fashion of what I did in Reflect, I'm going to be showing workflow tips and practices of how you can best use Forma and some ideas that you can apply to your upcoming projects. So let's get started. So what you're seeing right now is actually the Forma interface. In the beginning, you're going to see a products and profiles menu, and your profile is going to be the beginning of your own personal project with Forma. In this case, we're going to be demoing an interior design project. And so we'll go ahead and name the profile that. And for the products, we're going to pull in some assets that we have from an existing Unity prefab. So we'll go ahead and we'll find that prefab that exists within our library. And we've named it conveniently interior config. And what this consists of is conference room tables, chairs, couch, backdrop wall, some photographs on the wall, and some plants and light fixtures. So this is great. We can look around, we get a feel for what exists with the product, but now what's missing is the environment. And so Forma is really great about providing some default environments. They are very showroom themed right now. There will be some more environments that come with future updates, but what we need for this particular demo is probably something a little more along the lines of AEC or interior design. So I've got a sample environment that I pulled from a Maya build, and I'm going to take that now that I've imported it and pull it right into my interior design profile. And what we should see here are now the environment and the products living together in the same 3D space. What'll happen though is that things don't always get imported to the exact orientation, especially if you're pulling from different sources. And so with Forma, what we can very easily do, which you're seeing here happen, is adjusting the X, Y, Z coordinates to move our products to be nice and cleanly aligned with the environment. Okay, great. So once we've got our product set up in our environment, the next thing we want to do is actually start to create visibility variants. This is what Forma is all about. So I'm going to take the elements that exist in my lounge setting, as well as my conference room set, and I'm going to drag them over to begin creating these sort of visibility variants. Instantly, it's going to ask me to create the variants. I'm going to say, yes, I want two of them. And now without any further work, I've got two really great displays, two unique scenes in the same environment, just like that. It's already done. No more work needs to be done there. Now in the same set of the conference room, I want to pull apart the chairs so I can see the different variations of the chairs. Same way, very easy. You just click two variants. If there's two objects, if there's more, you click three, whatever the option is, Forma is actually going to present you with that. Now for best practices and keeping things nice and neat, we want to rename things to keep it organized. And so we'll call this the room setup and our conference seats. Following that, we want to create thumbnails. This is how you're going to keep visibility and know what you're toggling between when you start to deploy this to your mobile app, to your web page. And to create the thumbnail, all you do is position the camera to exactly where you want it. You'll get that preview, you'll save, and then you'll populate. And what's great about populating them is that you're going to get a thumbnail for every element that lives within that family of conference seats. We can do the same thing with our room setup. We'll go from the parent room setup, we'll save the thumbnail from that angle, and then the lounge setting and the conference room sets, those will all have the identical camera angle thumbnail for that. So now what we want to do is we want to start adding some colors to this couch. And so I can take from the FBX import the seat low element, which is the greater couch, I can import that over, and now I've got the material variant. From here, I can go into the material picker and use any of the default materials that are offered with Forma. I can also import my own materials and colors. And I can select whichever ones I like for my preference, take them from the library, drag them over to that couch material variant, and boom, there you go. Now I've got all of those materials nicely organized just under that. No extra work done. I can cycle through them. I can ping each color, and each one has its own unique visibility now in this scene. So just like what I did before with the thumbnails, I want to do the same thing. I'm going to go ahead, get my camera in place, populate a thumbnail, and now every single color has its own thumbnail. So we're going to go here in a moment and play the build so you can see what this actually looks like when we run this, whether it be again on any device you want to deploy to. But first, we're going to set the camera angle. This is the last piece that we want to focus on today. So setting the camera angle, the first one will ideally most likely be your default camera angle when you actually run the application. So we'll position this just similar to a thumbnail practice, be where we want to be, save the product, save the camera, and then run the application in Forma. Once we run it, now you're going to see this nice menu with dropdowns on the left side, the different variant sets we have. There's a category for price if you've got the pricing information. But just as you check those boxes, it's going to check through all of those visibility variants that you just created. This is a matter of minutes we've done this. This is no time at all to create a design review project configurator. And you see the camera being where we set that first camera orientation. And so now, just to add a little bit of extra perspective, we can add additional cameras. And so in this case, we've got one room to look at, but for a more practical design review, you may have the kitchen, the living room, the bathroom. You may have floors 1 through 10 of a commercial build, office building that you're designing. And so as each camera comes in, you can start to see the cut, ease in, ease out features we have so that we can choose how to go from one camera to the next. And once we've done that, we save the project again, we run it, and we can now switch from camera item to camera item one. And you can see very easily, it just snaps from one to the other. Now, that's great for an internal design review, but if you actually wanted to use this for a marketing and sales tool, you might want to add a little dramatic effect to your client or end user. And so we'll go back into the ease in, ease out, and add a little fade time of about 3 seconds. That should be enough to add just a little bit of drama when going from one camera to the next. So we'll see that happen here. The nice pullback, a 3 second fade, very nice and clean. This is all extremely easy to do. You do not have to be a Unity programmer to use Forma. That's what's most exciting about this product. I hope you like what you saw here today. We'll create more content for you to get your hands on. And if you do want to try Unity Forma, go to Unity's website, find the product Unity Forma, enter into a contact us form. And if you saw this video, you can put into the last box that you saw this video. You can ask to connect with me, Christopher Gonzalez, if you'd like. And I hope you enjoyed this, and I hope you will subscribe and look forward to future videos. Thank you.